Can a 5-cylinder make 4,000 horsepower or above that? Well, that's what we're going to find out today. So I'm going to explain something real quick if you don't know. This is called the short block. It's literally the bottom end of the engine. So it consists of the crankshaft, it consists of the block itself. And of course, it's your pistons, your piston rings, your crankshaft, your main caps, your rod caps. And you can't forget the oil pan and also all of the gaskets that go along with this. So you might be wondering, what is it then with the head on top but no intake or exhaust manifold? Well, that's what we call a long block. Long block is a pretty simple explanation, I'll get into it real quick. Just gonna touch lightly on the subject, but it includes, of course, everything in the short block. Then in the head, it's literally just your actual head itself. It's your valves, it's your valve springs, it's your valve keepers. It's your camshaft, it's the top of the camshaft caps. It's all the bearings and gaskets, and of course your valve covers go over the top. Of course, you can't forget about your spark plug cover if it's an inline 6 engine, or it's a dual overhead cam V engine, or a boxer engine. But so there's some interesting tidbits I'd like to add. So yeah. Now of course, as you can see there, this thing is starting to make power very, very quickly, and it's starting to make it very efficient. But we're running into some small problems, of course, with our pistons and conrods are starting to become a problem. But we'll quickly solve that by upping the RPM rev limiter. Somewhat solve it, but I think we're going to make it worse, actually. Valve float is going to become an issue, but that's okay. We have stiffer valve springs and lifters, of course, in there, so we can up that again a little bit. So we are at over 3,000 horsepower, almost at 4,000 horsepower, so we are quickly reaching my goal today. This is absolutely awesome, and if you like to see this engine in a chassis, do comment down below and consider to subscribe, because I'm gonna try to do that here in Wednesday's live stream, or midweek live stream, really. So yeah, if you want to see that, come hang out, we'll try and talk, and of course if my wonderful brain plays nicely, we can have a fantastic time. Anyway, back to the video. As you can see there, we're up to 3,900 horsepower, which is bizarre, but I love it. We're almost to my power goal, which is 4,000, if I need to remind. So that's good. So we can go back here to the exhaust system and try and increase our header size just a little bit so we can make more power. Note, we are looking very, 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 very tight when it comes to our pistons and rods being, well, severely stressed. I'm not making it easy on this engine, but we're almost to my power goal, I see. Pretty happy with that. I mean, 3,900 horsepower is already bizarre and insane, but I think we can go a little more. I really do think, and just like that, over 4,000 horsepower, this engine is absolutely beautiful. It's an inline 5, so this thing is going to sing beautifully. So we're going to have this engine painted right about now. This thing is looking absolutely beautiful, and let's do some dyno runs. So we're going to do dyno pulls, one looking at the engine, one looking at the graph. So let's see what this beautiful machine sounds like. That's a beautiful sounding inline 5, that's absolutely awesome. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you wonderful people next one. Bye bye.